أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today we are going to discuss digestion, rumination, deglutition, salivary secretion in ruminants. The digestive system is digestive system comprises on alimentary canal, gastrointestinal tract, and accessory glands. Salivary glands, pancreas, and liver are the main accessory glands which contributes in the digestive system. The portal for nutrients to gain access to the circulatory system. Mostly the food stuff like carbohydrate, protein, and fats are broken down to a very simple molecules. Resulting sugars, amino acids, fatty acids, and are then transported across the gastrointestinal tract, lining into blood. The specific food stuffs animals are able to utilize dependent on the type of digestive system they possess. Mostly the digestive systems functions of the digestive systems are the digestion means that the conversion of the complex food material in a diet into a simpler digestible form. So then the absorption, the digested food enters the blood circulation through gastrointestinal tract or a valve, and the digestive system can be classified of a domestic animal based on the type of a digestive system they possess, like monogastric or a simple stomach animals, ruminants like a cranial fermentator or a multi-compartment stomach animals, and others like hindgut, caudal fermentator, simple stomach, but very large and a complex large intestine, like a horse. the types of a digestive system, you can see the monogastric animals like the chicken, pigs, the turkey, the dogs, whereas the ruminants, which is the cranial fermentators, are beef cattle, dairy cattle, goat, sheep, and deer. The hindgut fermentators like horses, rabbits, and ostrich. The digestive system, which may be classified according to a domestic animal based on feeding habits, they may be the herbivorous. They eat the plants only, for example, cattle, horse, or sheep. Where the carnivores eat flesh of other animals like a dog, cat, lion. Omnivores, they eat the plants and animal both, like a human being, pigs, deers, squirrels, mouse, or the rats. The process of digestion, that is dependent on the seven steps. One is the prehension act of bringing the food into the mouth. Mostly the animals may bring the food by grabbing it through a tongue or chewing it with the lips and as well as with the teeth, or it may grab with the hands like a monkey. The ingestion, the taking into the food to a smallest via mechanical means into smallest particles. There's mastication means chewing, the deglutition means swallowing, the regurgitation means chewing the cud in ruminants. The ruminants have a capability to bring back the food, digested food, into the mouth and then regurgitate or remasticate, re-swallow, and re-saligation takes place in the ruminants. After the digestion, that the absorption takes place, the digested food enters the circulation through GIT bag, and assimilation means in the cell, food is either used for energy purpose or construct body tissues. So digestion, defecation, removal of the waste products. Type of digestion that as I told you that the digestion, which is breakdown of the material into the simplest mechanical parts, is known as the mechanical digestion, which takes place in the mouth. Physical breakdown of food during the mastication or a GIT wall contraction. The chemical and enzymatic digestion, with the help of the chemicals like hydrochloric acid in the stomach, which helps the animals to digest the food, and the enzymes, which may have to convert the large molecules, chemical molecules, into the simplest and diffusible molecules. So incomplete or a partial digestion means breakdown of food into the intermediate, but not a final products like starch, may be converted into maltose, but the maltose will not be absorbed until unless it may be converted into a glucose. So the complete digestion, like complex molecules, is spilled up into a final units, like protein may be converted into food atoms, like amino acids, which is absorbed in the form of amino acid into the bloodstream and then it is consumed. So the digestive system, type of digestion, intracellular digestion takes place inside the cell, and extracellular digestion takes place outside of the cell. Prehension, the seizing and conveying of food to the mouth or oral cavity. The method vary in a different animal, but in all domestic animals, lips, teeth, tongue are the principal organs of this function. Four limbs and hands are main prehensile organs in case of a pet animal and a human. The horses cause the prehension or bring the food into the mouth by lips, whereas the cow or a cattle, they bring the animal, the food into the mouth by a tongue, whereas the goat and sheep uses both the lips and the tongues to bring the food into the mouth, whereas the cat and the dog uses the forelimbs and the mouth to bring the food into the mouth, so that the cat and the dog is bringing the food into the mouth by using a forelimb and a mouth. Whereas the mastication, mechanical breakdown of the food in the mouth, especially the mouth, is the sake of or a cavity having a different parts. So the many vertebrates have a teeth using for a chewing and a mastication, whereas the birds lack the teeth and having a the breakup of a food in a two-chamber stomach that's known as a gizzard, and muscular chamber that uses the ingested pebbles to grind the food, whereas the birds lack the teeth but having a beak. Role of a mastication, act of a chewing, the jaw movements, that's reflexes. The physical breakdown of a food provides the larger surface area of the enzymatic reaction and stimulates the saliva secretion and less chewing in carnivores, more chewing in a herbivores. Proper mastication results in a bolus formation. In a carnivores and herbivores, jaw movements is vertical. In the herbivores, the lateral movement or upper jaw is wider than a lower jaw. So the role of the salivary glands and the saliva, there's a parotid, mandibular, sublingual, zygomatic, exocrine, or secrete the serous mucus or a mixed secretion to facilitate the mastication and deglutition. Whereas the role of salivary glands and saliva is to contain the salivary amylase and an enzyme that breaks down the starch into glucose and alkaline in the nature and reduce the pH in the stomach. The volume of saliva varies, but greatest in the herbivores, like in a cow, it may be from a 25 to a 50 gallons, means 100 to 200 liters per day. Additional function of a neutralization of large amounts of acid that are produced as a result of a fermentation to meet the buffering and demand the ruminal saliva contains the bicarbonate phosphate buffers and particularly the bacterial growth. The role of salivary glands and saliva is to salivation is controlled by the nervous system. Tasting, smelling, and even the thinking or taking of about a food stimulate the increased saliva in the mouth. Deglutination is the act of a swelling convey of a food mass bolus from the mouth of the stomach. Suitable digestion of the swelling generally mild line between the tongue and the heart plate for a swelling. There are three stages of a swelling. One is through the mouth, which is voluntarily, and through the pharynx on the basis of a reflex, and through the esophagus, it is again on the basis of a reflex, it takes place. So the deglutition is the food is in a contact with the receptors of the mucous membrane of a posterior part of mouth and with the posterior wall of the phalanx. So impulses from the receptors pass along the glossopharyngeal, the superior laryngeal branch of the vagus nerve, and the maxillary division of the trigeminal nerve to the swelling center in the medulla. Collection of the nerves are located in the fourth ventricle of the brain. The whole process is completed in a 0.5 to 0.7 seconds. The gastric glands, which plays a very important role, there are three types of glands are present. One is the cardiac gland, the fundus gland, the pyloric gland. The cardiac gland produces the mucus, the fundus gland produces the hydrochloric acid and as well as the pepsinogen, whereas the pyloric gland is producing the mucus and the gastric. So the gastric acid secretion is stimulated by acetylcholine parasympathetic and the gastrin and a histamine and amino acid driver to present in the most of the body tissues. A normal pH is 3.5 to 5 or below the pH of 2, the inhibition of the gastric secretions occur. So the variation in the digestive systems, like the digestive tract of some animals contain a bacteria, protists that convert the cellulose into the substances the host can absorb the minor in humans, essential to some animals. Herbivores have a longer digestive tract. The greater time of the digestion of cellulose, modification to enhance the digestion of plant materials. The variation in the digestive system, the rodents, horses, deer, and the rabbits digest the cellulose in the cecum, whereas the regurgitation of the contents is not possible. However, some such animals practice coprophagy, whereas they eat their feces to absorb the nutrients on the second phase of a food. Which cannot remain healthy if fermented from the eating feces. So the variation in the digestive systems, all animals rely on intestinal bacteria to synthesize vitamin K, which is required for the blood clotting. The birds, which lacks these bacteria, must consume the required quantities of the vitamin K in their diet. So the control links food intake to an energy balance is regulation of the food intake depends on the leptin, the peptide hormones, the key to an appetite control, whereas they produce by adipose tissues. leptin receptors located in the hypothalamus reduce the leptin signals brain to intake food, and research on a leptin in a human is ongoing. Whereas the regulation of food intake, other hormones involved in the control of feeding and energy includes the insulin, GIP, CCK, which signals satiety. Whereas the ghrelin, which stimulates the food intake and the control of feeding. So the neuropeptides induces the feeding activity. And thank you very much. This is the digestive system, which is elaborated over here, that how the ruminants are non-ruminants, like a simple stomach animals may have to eat the food and digest it, and it may have to process from mouth to the anus to defecate the waste products. So it means that the digestion is one of the process in which the mastication, deglutition, the absorption, and as well as ejection may have to take place. So you have to go through this lecture for the contents, and these contents have been given to you in a photocopy. And then after verifying these that data which has been given in a form of a hard copy, that can be verified from this lecture. So thank you very much. You have to share this lecture with other students, and as well as you have to subscribe to the channel so that the students may obtain its maximum benefit. Thank you very much.